Can we move on to the next question then?
Yeah.
Next question is, find the area bounded by, find the area bounded by y is equal to mod of ln of mod x and y equal to 0. Find the area bounded by mod of ln of mod x and y equal to 0. Needless to tell you, y equal to 0 is your x-axis actually. So remember, step number one, plot the graph. So the biggest prerequisite of this chapter is graphs. We cannot proceed without knowing the graph. So first let us, okay, you just take 1 minute and plot this graph, and then I'll tell you how to deal with this graph. Are you done with the graph? Okay, first of all, let's talk about y is equal to ln x. Forget about any mod. How does this graph look like? This graph actually looks like this. Correct? And if you're modding x, what happens? Let me go step by step. If you're modding x, what happens? You just have to make the same graph on the other side as well. Like this. Okay. So this is the graph of, this entire thing is the graph of ln of mod x. Correct? Now, when you mod this, what happens? Let's go to the step number four. Let me choose the blue color. What do you do with the graph? The part which is below the x-axis will now go above the x-axis. That means this part will now go like this. Yes or no? Okay. Similarly, this part will also go above like this. Yes or no? And these two parts will get erased off. These two parts will get erased off. Right? So this is your final graph of mod of ln of mod x. And let me show this to you on the GeoGebra as well. So y is equal to mod of do you see this?
Yeah.
Now these two arms will come very close to each other, but they will never actually touch each other. Are you getting this point?
Yeah.
Yes. Now, how would I get this area? How would I get the area which is between these two? That means, how do I get this entire area? That is the question.
Is it that, as you said, sir, before, we have to consider it both vertical and horizontal strips. So, so we can consider...
Do you want to consider horizontal strips over here?
Horizontal strips in the blue area. Can we do that?
Yeah, of course. This is the final graph. So there's no blue and green now. So we have to find this area right now. Okay. So what I'm trying to say here is that if you want to find this area, can we first focus on finding the area of this part?
Yeah.
Can I say doubling up this area would give me the answer?
Yeah, because it's symmetrical.
Right. So area would be nothing but twice the area of this part. Let me call it as A1. Okay. Now first focus on getting the equation of this blue line. What is the equation of this blue line? Because of so many mods, we tend to lose track that which curve represents what, or what is the equation of this arm of the curve. So can somebody tell me what is this blue line do you see the cursor moving on the screen? My cursor? Or let me just show you this part. This part. Okay. What is the equation of that part I want to know? Do you realize that it is y equal to ln x, mirrored image about x axis? This line is a part of y is equal to ln x. It's a part of y is equal to ln x, mirrored about the x axis. Yes or no?
Yes.
So if a curve is mirrored image about x axis, what is going to be its equation? Minus y equal to ln x. Correct?
Yeah.
And my dear students, if I am going to take horizontal strips for it, I would need this as x equal to e to the power minus y. Yes or no?
Yes.
So can I say A1 area, I'm calling this area as the A1 area and A as my final answer. So how would I get A1 area? Can I say A1 area would be integral of minus e to the power minus y dy from 0 to infinity? Yes or no?
Yeah.
And this is nothing but gamma 1, which is known to us as 1. So for the students who are not aware about gamma function, just a quick highlight on what's a gamma function. Gamma n is basically integral from 0 to infinity e to the power minus x, x to the power n minus 1 dx. Right? You can also write it by changing the variable as e to the power minus y, y to the power n minus 1 dy, doesn't make a difference. And if you put your n as 1, this term is going to disappear because y to the power 1 minus 1 is y to the power 0, which is going to be 1. Anyhow, if you do not want to get into improper integrals, you can still solve this. So let me just clear this up. You can still solve this very easily. You just have to integrate it from 0 to b e to the power minus y dy and take the limit on b tending to infinity, which is just going to be minus e to the power minus y from b to infinity. So it is minus e to the power minus b minus of minus 1. And as b tends to infinity, this will become 0. So your answer will be 1. So A1 is going to be 1. Any doubt about this? So A is going to be 2A1, which is nothing but 2 into 1. So your answer will be 2 square units.
Sir, so yes. When we are writing the exam and we get such a type of an integral,
right?
It's safer to remember the improper integrals.
Yeah, you can just verify your answer by using the improper integrals.
Okay. Yeah.
After all, these improper integrals have been derived from our basic understanding of definite integrals, right?
Yeah.
Great. Can we take a question which is very similar to this?
Yeah, sure.
I'm clearing the screen now. Okay. Next question is, find the area enclosed between y is equal to ln x plus e and x is equal to ln 1 by y and the x-axis. Solve this. Right. So now, without, don't look at the screen. I will be just drawing my curves. Yeah, now you can just check. Did you get this figure?
Yes, sir.
And we need this area. Please note that this area is open from this side, right? So even if it is open, the sum is going to be finite because e to the power minus x is basically a convergent term. So it is going to just die down on the x-axis. However, we'll never touch it. We say that x-axis is going to be an asymptote to this function. Okay. Now, how many different types of strips will be required here?
Two strips.
Very good. Two strips. One will be like this. Correct? And the other one would be like this. Yes or no? Right? Now, for this strip, let me draw the other one with a different color so that we can easily identify it. Let this be red. Yeah. So for the blue strip, what expression should I write? Anyone? Which is the upper curve for this strip? First, tell me the equation of that curve. Tell me the y for that curve. Why I'm taking y for that curve? Because I'm using vertical strips. Then y for the lower part of the strip. Tell me these two things. Ln
x plus e.
X plus e minus zero.
Zero, yeah.
Correct?
Mm.
And I'm integrating this from which value of x to which value of x? 1 minus e to zero. Correct? So this definition will last only from this point till this point. Correct? Plus. Now for this red strip, tell me the y of the upper part of the strip. you will say e to the power minus x. Lower part of the strip, again zero. See, I'm just writing this zero for clarity. In the normal case, you may not choose to write that also. Okay. And integrate this from zero to which point? Does it stop anywhere?
Infinity.
No, yeah, it goes all the way to infinity. Correct. So now we have to evaluate this integral. Now, while evaluating this integral, you may choose to substitute x plus est. Okay. And your dx will still remain your dt. So this integral, the double ticked one, will convert as ln t dt. Okay. What will be the lower limit? When you put x as 1 minus c, lower limit will be 1. And when you put x as 0, upper limit will be e. And this answer is very well known to us. It is gamma 1, whose answer is 1. What is ln t integration? T ln t minus 1. Upper limit e, lower limit 1. So when you put e, you get a 0. And when you put a 1, you get minus of minus 1. So your answer will finally be 1 plus 1, which is nothing but 2 square units again. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay.